call you the Jackal. My mother gave me that name because when I was born, I had a birthmark on my back that was exactly like you after the Mediterranean Sea. No, of course not. I'm a prince. I send others to sail along the west coast of Africa. Spread Christianity, make new maps, find traders. I love trade. I'll give you a shiny trinket for that microphone.
I can't do that. This belongs to
Bob.
I thought I had reached East Indies in China.
Portugal and Spain signed a treaty to divide the new Western territory with an imaginary line, the line of demarcation that ran through the Atlantic. All the lands to the east was Portugal's, and all the lands to the west belonged to Spain.
Wait, wait. If you're Italian, how can you say you're from Spain? And what kind of food did you eat? Did you bring pizza on the Spanish ship? Or would you get in trouble?
My requests for funding was rejected by the grounds of Portugal, Italy, France, and England. Even King Ferdinand and Queen Isabella made me wait 6 years until they had finished the Reconquista and driven the Muslims out of Granada. But finally, in 1492...
Wait, I know this one. In 1492, you sailed the Ocean Blue. Although, that's kind of a lame rhyme. Ocean Blue? Who says that? It should have been something like, in 1492, Columbus sailed a big canoe. In 1493, Columbus sailed a big blue sea. I think it's okay to change history if you're wrong.
I did make a second trip in 1493, and 1498, and 1502. I thought I only had to sail 3,000 miles westward to reach Asia, and Golden Spice is waiting in Japan and the Spice Islands. But it was more like 12,000 miles, and there were a couple unknown continents, and a lot of islands along. I never did figure out what went wrong.
You thought the Caribbean was Asia? Couldn't you tell by the reggae music?
Thank you.
Excuse me, pardon me. Hi, I'm Sam Spectacle with...
Bow, 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 bow!
The best new show ever! Are you Miss Fucci? That's right, Miss Fucci.
They named America after him!
I like to think of the new continent as Miss Fucci, but America's cool.
He sailed several times to South America and claimed that whole buff on the eastern side of the continent for Portugal.
Wait, but didn't Columbus land on South America several years before you?
Why are you hating on America?
And what about Pedro the Frog? Didn't he get blown off course and bump into Brazil too?
Stop all your facts! You're freaking me out!
Hey, see, it's all cool, see? I figured out that this place isn't Asia at all, but a new continent. I sailed up and down the coast looking for a way through. I didn't find one, but hey, you don't have to be the first to be the best.
Explorers of North America to give us some weather tips.
is John Cabot and Jacques Cartier. Tell me, John, what was the weather like when you landed in Newfoundland in 1497?
It was cold, Sonny, but that didn't stop me. I was looking for a way to sail through the continent of North America to get to Asia. Today, they call this route the Northwest Passage. And back then, we didn't know where it was, but we just knew it had to be there somewhere. I was the first European to sail to the mainland of North America.
You mean the second?
I gave you a chance for entry.
I really like gold. Gold is man's best friend.
So in 1513, we became the first Europeans to see the eastern shore of what is now the Pacific Ocean, and all the other groups was followed the new.
To be honest, we're not really the victims here.
We have
my brother love this time?
Absolutely.
Did you find Coronado?
Absolutely, Isabel. What a beautiful river island. I just love San Diego.
No, that's fabulous.
I got a massage and...
You were supposed to find Francisco Vázquez de Coronado, the Spanish conquistador.
Another one? Jesus, Isabel. How many of these European explorers are there?
I gave you a list of tracks out of this morning's meeting.
Those are like all dead guys?
That's what the show is about. Look at this. How that was that?
University?
No. The explorer who planned in Mississippi and Ohio back to France. Champlain.
I thought that was a lake.
Named after one of the first men to establish a permanent settlement in Canada. DeSoto?
I know that one.
That's Carr.
That hasn't been made since 1960.
Oh, maybe that explains the four of their just Spanish guys
who've been flying around all day.
I don't think I want to hear about this.
They were all like, blah, 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 DeSoto, about some important stuff that ought to come about history.
Oh, look, I see them now.
I'm so sorry. I've been trying.
I take full responsibility for this lost paper.
We came out flat. But my 5 ships left Spain in 1519. We weren't mentally prepared. We thought we'd find the Southwest Passage through the Americas to the ocean on the other side. We came up a little short.
What was it? Too many off-field distractions? Nagging injuries? Did your team not stay hungry?
Oh, trust me, we were hungry all the time. Turnovers killed us. A couple of my ships deserted. We lost our focus. We sailed all the way around the tip of South America and into the Pacific Ocean, but we never came together as a team.
And then you were killed in the Philippines?
Those natives just made the big plays and we didn't. They out-hustled us.
But one of the ships in 1277 on your team did make it across the Pacific and back to the first men to sail around the globe.
They gave 110% people. Those guys have nothing to be ashamed of. They're scrappy players, and I'm glad they'll be returning, but it's still going to be a rebuild.
So what's ahead of you now, Coach?
Well, I'm dead, of course, and seem to have lost a step or two. It's a business, baby. I get that. It's all about winning and losing. But I'm looking forward to spending more time with my family.
Thanks, Coach. That was Ferdinand Magellan, Wiley Veteran Insurance for the Explorer Hall of Fame in the Pacific Ocean and the passage around South America. It's called the Strait of Magellan. Now let's talk to the winning team from England, Francis Drake and his crew from the Golden Hind. Coach Drake, congratulations for the big win for England in 1380.
Sure, thanks. You know what happened, right?
A win is a win, Coach.
We just wanted to sail around South America and steal some silver from the Spanish ships in the Pacific.
We pirates!
But you were the first men to command a complete voyage around the globe.
We didn't really need to do that.
Nah, but once we robbed all those Spanish ships off Peru, we figured it was easier just to keep going than to try to sail back through the Spanish fleet.
We sailed north past California. Couldn't find a passage through America, so we headed west to the Spice Islands. 3 years later, we made it back to England.
We were heroes and scouts.
Who knew?
The captain here even got a knighthood. Later, as vice admiral in the English Navy, he thwarted the Spanish Armada that was attempting to invade England.
But really,
I just want to be a pirate.
Thanks for coming.